that was supposed to be a place where the ideas of science and exploration and medicine and all the things that we've grown in over the last three or four centuries, in such, particularly in the last century, so quickly, is able to grow without sort of versions of politics holding it down. It was able to grow because it was pure, and they just said, "This is the smartest people. These are the most interested people." All working for the same goal, which is to make their world better and hope that that can spread. I play Frank, and I'm a disenchanted grump who was a bit of a dreamer as a young boy and sort of a smart little scientist kid, and goes to a place that he thinks is going to be the greatest place on earth, and they're going to be able to grow, and the world is going to be much better because of it. And finds out that all of those things were untrue, and in so doing, he becomes probably the most cynical person you could be, more cynical than most, I think. And he isolates himself and plans to spend the rest of his life there, and then is sort of forced to deal with his past because of situations that happen in the film. Young Frank is an inventor. He's invented a backpack rocket, and he gets there by being invited by a certain guest who sees him at the World's Fair and decides that perhaps this young man might be one of the sort of chosen, smart, hopeful, interesting people who could perhaps make this new world grow and work much better. And that's sort of who he is. It's a little family dynamic, but the problem is that the youngest one is the parent. Casey and I are like the two fighting kids, and Athena is the, she's driving and she's telling the kids to shut up. I mean, so it's a very backward family. We're having, I'm a big kid who didn't really ever grow up and still mad and sort of stopped evolving at around 11 years old. And we are fighting all the time, particularly Casey and I, and Athena and I. So it is a family dynamic, but it's all turned upside down because the real parent in it is the youngest version. Britt's just a fantastic young actress, and she's, there's a lot of things. She had to do a lot of physical stuff. She had to work really hard. She had to audition, 50 times or something for the part. So she was really put through the ringer on every level on this thing. And she's who we hang our hat on the film. She's the through line. She's who we have to ride it out with. And this is the first time for her to do something that, certainly on this scale. And she did it like a champ. And most important for me was that she enjoyed herself and made it enjoyable for everybody else on the set. Because the truth of the matter is, when you go and you work on a movie for a long period of time, that becomes your home and your family. If you do what I do for a living, then crews and cast members are as much a part of your family as your family, because you spend as much time or more time with them. And so it requires a really generous spirit, and she has all of those. And it was an absolute joy to work with her. Rafi shows up and it's just her. She's just naturally in it. And she's not sort of look at me mom kind of kid actor. She's just very present, very funny, very philosophical. Got a great outlook. She's also really skilled, really talented actress. I expect a lot of big things from her. Well, Brad hasn't made a bad film. I mean, if you think about it, Iron Giant, which is his first big film, is a masterpiece. And then, The Incredibles and Ratatouille and Ghost Protocol. I mean, he just makes good films. He's incredibly passionate about the project. He's really sweet and fun to work with. His whole family was there. His wife was working there. And, it was really hot. She's coming out with bottles of water. It was, for a big old studio picture, there was very, it very much was like a family film. And Brad, that all starts with the director.